Earlier, this week's marquee matchup, arguably one of the biggest regular season games in LA football history. Under the Saturday night lights of Aloha Stadium, top-ranked and undefeated Punahou going toe-to-toe with number 3 St. Louis. With a victory, Buff and Blue can secure a fifth straight league championship, while the Crusaders can force a winner-take-all ILH title game next weekend with a win. 3 weeks ago, an instant classic where behind Wayne Taulapapa's 164 yards and 4 touchdowns, Punahou erased a 14-point deficit, winning in double overtime 51-45. Will the Wing Doe remain as the symbol of dominance, or will the Dukes Up Knight live to fight another day? It's Hanahou between Hawaii's heavyweights in Halawa.
You want to take care of business as soon as possible, and I think that's how we approach it. We've had to do it the last few years, so we're kind of prepared for that. And it's always nice to know in the back of your mind that you have another opportunity if you need it, but you want to go all in and make sure you do everything you can to compete as hard as possible.
Playing against Puno is a blessing. I mean, we haven't beat them for so long. And if we were to beat them, I guess breaking the streak would kind of solidify what kind of team that we really are this year.
I just think it's going to be another war. I mean, I don't know how you top a double overtime walk-off touchdown to win, but I still think it's going to be another great game. And, you know, if St. Louis wins, there's a chance we see it a third time. So, it's going to be fun.
It doesn't happen every year. You got two great traditions, two great powerhouses, well-coached teams, and, you know, they lay it all on the line. And to be a part of that is always special. And I might even pay if I wasn't in the game. So sure. Come on, everybody should come out and just watch it and enjoy.
Now, in Punahou's win a few weeks ago, junior Nick Kapule posted 3 touchdowns, but back from a shoulder injury, senior Ephraim Tuliloa is expected to start Saturday against the Crusaders. A coach, I'm sure Kaliane and company, extremely confident with 2 capable quarterbacks, perhaps the most important player in the state in Wayne Taulapapa. And over the last few weeks, what's turned out to be a legit receiving core in Ethan Takeyama and Eamon Brady, right?
Yeah, and they're trying to make up for Kanavai Noah, last year's the most prolific receiver in Hawaii history. And both Ethan Takeyama and Eamon Brady have been a large part of Punahou's success. Coach Leonard Lau, the former University of Hawaii wide receiver, said both of these guys are tireless workers and very competitive. Ethan's a little dinged up, Rob. I'm not sure his availability.
Well, on the other sideline, the talent is obvious there. Tua Tagovailoa had his millionth national write-up on him last week in Sports Illustrated, but it's under the helmet that perhaps prevented the Crusaders from winning that game 3 weeks ago with timely penalties on defense specifically. Do you think that's still a concern for St. Louis?
Well, penalties are always a concern and discipline for all coaches, but I know this is a concern of Cal Lee. But one thing I did notice during the Iolani game last weekend, they had cut down their penalties. They were much more disciplined, and that's going to be way more important, Rob, come this Saturday as well as the playoffs, if they're in the playoffs.
All right. Well, not since Wayne's World has a sequel been so anticipated. Again, Punahou win gives the Buff and Blue the ILH title and a ticket into the state tournament. A St. Louis victory forces an ILH title game next weekend. Get there early, folks. Huge crowd expected. And if you can't make it, turn that dial to AM 1500. All right, we got the rubber slippers on our hands flying here on Cover 2. Time to take a quick timeout. When we come back, we go to Ever Beach for this week's pop quiz. Plus, Sam Spangler takes us on campus to Kaimuki.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We're down here at Big City Diner where we're so full after lunch, I feel like we just covered 2 separate meals. Coming up after the break, we're headed on campus to Kaimuki, where head coach David Tautofi left his dreams of going to the big city after seeing something so shocking, he felt he needed to come home. You're watching Cover 2.
Cover 2 is proudly sponsored by Domino's, GEICO, and Straw Bone and Joint Center.